Seen her around here?
Sorry.
Her name's Paris. She's been missing for 3 weeks and her parents are really worried about her. She was into the scene.
All I do is serve them drinks.
Years ago, my son was taken from me. Since then, I've lost everything. My job, my marriage, even my life. But I came back, and the dead came with me.
Gotcha.
We made more flyers, and we posted them everywhere.
We just need the right person to see it.
You're not any closer to finding her, are you?
I've hit all the clubs, and I still don't have any leads on the boyfriend.
I can't believe I didn't get his name.
I've also talked to her landlord several times and to the regulars at a nearby coffee shop, but I still haven't come across anyone who knows Paris, except her neighbors who've just seen her coming and going.
Can't take this again.
Again.
We lost our older daughter in a car accident a few years ago.
I'm terribly sorry.
After that, Paris lost her way. Drinking a little, staying out late. We tried everything.
Why didn't you tell me this before?
We didn't want you to get the wrong idea about her.
Paris has some problems, but she wouldn't just run off and leave us to worry. She called us. Every week. Please. Find her.
Right.
Hey, you're busy. I'll catch up with you later.
I'm just finishing up. Don't touch it. Keep it clean, all right? Stay smart. What's up, brother?
Not much.
Did you see that game the other night?
Yeah. Don't ask me what the score was.
Pretty occupied.
Working on this missing persons case. This girl. She's dead, but I don't have any proof.
Well, then how do you know she's dead?
Oh. I've seen her. All the pieces are there. They just don't add up. I can't find a body. Checked out all the Jane Does, been to the morgues.
Funeral parlors, graveyards, and big city morgues. My grandmother used to say they were the noisiest places on earth. She called them gray zones because they were filled with unrequited spirits caught in transition.
Limbo.
Mm-hmm.
Unable to move on or stay. Till when?
I think that's where you come in.
Frank Taylor. I'm a private investigator.
You can call me Tyranny.
So when was the last time you saw Paris, Tyranny?
It's been a while, I guess. We had a fight. I was wrong about something. Anyway, we didn't talk after that. But now I think something's happened to her.
Me too.
You're the first person that I've met who thinks that. Everybody else just thinks she's banished off the face of the earth. All I know is you're looking in the wrong place, Frank. Paris was in the scene.
That's not this?
This is just a place. It's Tuesday at the Mayan. Synth pop and Brit stuff. The scene isn't a place.
What, it's a state of mind?
No, it's downstairs. A promoter put a velvet rope up, called the club Desolation, and lured the scene there.
And that's where Paris was?
Inside. That's where you've got to follow Paris. I've got to go.
How do I get there? Inside.
Same way she did. Down the rabbit hole.
Michelle.
Frank.
You with the record company?
No,
I think I saw you at the Standard last week, or Moomba.
Oh, it was that Xbox party at Leo's.
Mm-hmm. I was hoping to hook up with Paris.
Oh, my God, we love Paris.
You know her?
Paris makes herself known.
When was the last time you saw her?
You know, the whole scruffy Johnny Depp meets Tom York thing really works for you.
About Paris. You saw her...
A party. 3 weeks ago? Mm-hmm.
Connor and Blake's place.
Right. But after that, nothing.
And you're not worried about her?
Come on.
People come and they go. I mean, anybody else, I think, well, she was left looking for the next bigger, better.
But... but not Paris. She already owned it.
What do you mean?
Connor Hewitt?
Snap off, you liar! You don't know what you're talking about. You can't tell the story to save your life.
He really had a thing for her.
Come on.
And what does Connor do?
He and his brother Blake are in Grievous Angels, like the coolest band to come out of England in, like, what, forever? He's the singer.
In Paris.
Like, totally hooked him.
Alcohol now. Right. Go back to the loft, all right? Frank Taylor. You with Grievous Angels, right?
Yeah. Paul Kingsley, I manage them for my sins. So I haven't seen you around here before. What, are you a producer? Manager?
Manager.
Right, who do you rep?
Indie bands. Wicked City, Gunsmith Cats, G-Force.
Well, I never heard of them.
There are no Grievous Angels.
Yeah, this town's lousy with imports, but they could go all the way.
Come on!
At least Connor could.
He sure seems to have the attitude. Although the others seem a little like session players.
Red shirts. Only there to get fired when Connor goes into a rage.
Well, Blake's got it made. Connor would never fire his own brother.
He hasn't yet. Blake's good for me, though. He keeps Connor on track.
Connor sounds like a volatile guy.
Yeah, he's a football hooligan with a guitar.
I heard there was a girl that Connor was hot for, named Paris.
But you're not a bloody manager. What are you really after?
Hey, Frank, party at the guy's place. You coming?
Sure.
Can we get you a ride?
You're both 18, right?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Paris had been doing the mailing list for Desolation's promoter, so she had this cool job, and she fell for Connor.
So if Paris fell for Connor, why would she disappear?
She probably woke up and realized it wasn't gonna happen.
Frank, she's gone. I mean, we're here.
Yeah, we're here.
So you found your way in?
Yeah. The ninth circle of Wonderland.
It just takes some getting used to.
Why would you want to?
Some people are made for it. The ones that aren't don't understand. It's like a family. A backstabbing weird one, but if you don't have anything else.
Paris didn't have anything else?
She gave it away.
What about you? Everybody needs more than this.
Not everybody.
Right. Top 10 ghost scores in order. Charleston, Fox, Spence. Who's next? You don't know, do you? Do you?
Right. You're such a big fan. Where's the official ring?
I don't know, and who cares? It's not about merchandise, it's about sport.
Come on. Right. If you don't have a home jersey hanging in your closet, you're not a real fan. Right, mate?
If you don't have a Lakers flag stuck on your SUV, might as well root for the Celtics.
Yeah.
It's about sport.
Sort off, you bastard. Thanks, mate. If you hadn't have stepped in, you'd have gone on all night.
Glad to help.
So, who the hell are you?
Frank Taylor. I'm a private investigator. I'm looking for, Paris. You know Paris, right?
Yeah, I've seen her around. Not lately.
I heard you were, close.
Yeah, whatever you heard from her is a lie.
Well, she's been missing since the party here 3 weeks ago, right after you guys played the Troubadour. What time did she leave?
Early.
So she was here?
Yep, there's a lot of girls here. Connor wasn't paying her much attention. She got messed drunk, threw in a cab, sent her home. End of story.
Except she never got there.
It's not her problem, mate. Right. Whoever you bloody are, I think you should leave. Before we have to throw a unicorn. You know what I mean?
The department's been through this already, Frank.
No cab company picked up a fare at that address. I don't think Paris ever left the loft.
What else?
She worked for a promoter of the club, but apparently in an unofficial capacity.
Who's the promoter?
No idea. Now give me the runaround on that. You don't suppose...
All right, what's the name of the club?
Desolation. Tuesdays at the Mine. Now, when Paris told her parents she was seeing a musician, she meant Connor Hewitt. Paris thought that she was in love with him.
And this Connor thought he was in love with her?
But he wasn't. And when she pushed it, when she started telling people about the
love stories go sour all the time, Frank. They don't always end in murder.
Marcus.
Look, you got no murder weapon, no witnesses, and no body. Find a reason for me to believe that a crime has been committed, I'll get in the game.
Jim's not coming.
I have a strange question. Did the song Long, Long Time mean anything to Paris?
How do you know about that?
A line of investigation that I'm pursuing.
I used to sing it to Paris when she was little. Paris always wanted one last glass of water. She wouldn't go to sleep. So, I would sing to her. And the only song that worked was that one. Oh, she loved it. You think she's dead, don't you? You said did. Did the song mean anything to Paris?
Yes. I'm afraid that I do. It's been 3 weeks since she's been gone, and...
Yeah. Whatever you find out, I want to know the truth.
Taylor.
It's me. I got your promoter for Club Desolation. Here's his name.
What are you doing here?
Finishing our conversation.
I've checked you out. You've got no right to harass Connor.
Connor's guilty of murder, and you're gonna help me prove it.
Oh, yeah, a fat chance.
Laugh, but I did my homework too. Seems Desolation is your club, which means that Paris worked for you. Now, if you're protecting Connor because he killed a girl that worked for you, that could make you an accessory.
All I did was tell him to stay away from her.
What about the song Long, Long Time?
What about it?
What does it mean to Connor?
I have no idea. All I know is that Connor was always goosing Blake about recording that song.
Where do they record?
In a converted building across the street from the loft. I'll send you a comp CD when it's finished. Are you about done here?
One last question. Paris didn't have a computer. How did she help you with the mailing list?
The girls work by cell phone. The club gave her one.
So it's listed to you.
Yeah.
I'm watching you and I'm watching my back. I made a better full of you, and as a matter of fact, I don't care what you're thinking, I don't care what you say. I'm gonna do what I do, so it doesn't matter anyway. You got me down, but I hang by a thread. Pissing on you, all the things that I never said. Take it, keep it, offer yourself.
Bonnie.
Hello, Connor. Just getting up.
Get out of here.
There's nobody here. I already checked.
What do you want?
Your relationship with Paris wasn't casual.
We just had it off a few times. Had some laughs.
Well, I'm a little confused, so maybe you can help me out here. First, it was that you'd just seen her around. Then you put her in a cab because she was too drunk to drive. And now you just had it off a few times. I mean, maybe if I keep asking, you'll get around to the truth.
Which is?
I had a very long phone conversation with Paris 3 weeks ago. Right after she got off her cell phone with a Dr. Martin at Alderson Pregnancy Clinic.
This isn't the dark ages, mate. Getting a girl pregnant isn't gonna ruin my career.
But killing her because she was trying to control you might.
I don't operate that way.
Well, you didn't plan to, but you let her in, and then you wanted her gone. Trouble is, she didn't want to go, so you had to make her. Long, long time. Does that mean anything to you?
No idea what you're going on about.
Well, let me spell it out for you, mate. All I have to do is prove that Paris never left this place. I prove that. The cops will be here in 5 minutes getting very acquainted with your DNA.
I don't believe you.
Showing me the same things over and over again.
Such as?
Blood, glass, bloody handprints, a song. Seems important to her.
She's dying again and again and again. For you, Frank. You're the only person from both worlds who can be her witness, man. Okay, blood and glass, huh?
Imprints that vanish.
They vanish?
Yeah. What does that mean?
Either means blood that can't be seen, or if it was there,
someone cleaned it up.
Oh.
Music, glass, the studio. This one's on me, buddy.
Please, man.
What are you doing here?
I saw your light. Did you pick that lock?
Yes. Come on.
Cool. This is the bomb.
You shouldn't be hanging out with these guys. They're dangerous.
You think someone hurt Paris, don't you?
Don't you have a curfew or something?
Don't be getting all Brady Bunch on me, Frank.
Somebody should. Was killed in here. Tierney,
no.
I think maybe you should.
I want to know.
Okay. You had to drag her out of the booth. And there's no back door out of here, so. Out through the front. He has to ditch her.
I'd say she died of shock and loss of blood about 3 weeks ago. The beating itself was a proximate cause of death.
Proximate? You mean she wasn't dead when she was dumped?
Not likely. She might have lived if she made it to the hospital.
What about these cuts on her face?
They're haphazard, not incised wounds. Looks like she was hit with something, not deliberately cut.
We need to speak with Connor Hewitt. He was sleeping with Paris. Frank, she was pregnant, Marcus, and Connor was the father. Now, those marks on her face could have been made by a piece of jewelry. Connor's got this soccer ring. He was bragging about what a big fan he is.
Let's go talk to him.
We're gonna find the person that did this. I promise you.
She wasn't dead, you know. Mm-mm. She suffered. I'm talking truth here, Connor.
You didn't just stash a body, you trashed the mother of your baby. And death comes slow on a cold and lonely night.
She hit me.
Why?
She thought I was gonna dump her. I can't remember much more. I was lagered, you know?
Right, you were drunk, huh?
Right.
Co. X.
Whatever was there.
So she hit you. And then?
It was loud. She was screaming. Being a bitch, she just wouldn't shut it. I remember, you know? And then I did. I had hit the window. There was blood. On the window and everywhere.
And then? Be happy
because a spoiled kid confessed to killing a girl that loved him.
The law doesn't care that she loved him, Frank, only that he killed her.
She deserves better.
Guess what? You were right. Your brother was innocent.
I told you he was. It's about time you lads came to your senses.
Yeah, he just thought that he killed her because he was high and suggestible.
What are you on about?
Found this at the recording studio with the rest of the demos.
This is for Paris.
Connor recorded this for Paris. They were happy. Which must have made you very unhappy.
Oh, right, right, right. So now you think I've done it, right? Coming after me. I was having enough of her, right? No reason to kill her.
Connor was listening to her more than he was listening to you. See, Connor remembers fighting with Paris. She thought that he was gonna dump her. I mean, I wonder where she got that impression.
What's the way it goes, all right? Difficult?
And the way Connor is, right? And it's your job to keep tabs on him, isn't it?
Right.
And you were keeping a very close eye on him that night, weren't you? Mm-hmm. You heard them fighting in the studio. I mean, Connor's usually fighting with somebody. But what really bothered you was Connor recording Paris's favorite song. This song. This song that you hate. And that's when you realized that your years of controlling your brother were over. And you just lost it.
Wake up!
She was pounding up against the glass, trying to, screaming to get Connor to wake up, and you just slammed it right into the glass, didn't you? Connor watched you kill her.
You're bluffing. You can't prove a thing.
I can prove that you lost your ring down the drain, washing the blood off your hands. See, the police have Connor's ring, which makes that one yours.
Her blood was on it.
I didn't believe them when they told me.
Bastard!
No, it was always going to keep you on your legs.
Come on.
I come in and you pass out as usual.
She says to me she's pregnant, right? You've always been in trouble ever since you've been a kid. I bloody hate you!
Will you kill her? She has your right on your thumb and you didn't even notice.
I loved her!
You have the right to remain bloody silent.
I remember. We were standing on the bridge. She was all wrapped up.
Now you remember pieces of it. You were helping Blake dispose of her body. He was not helping you.
Killed her.
Connor.
Just naff off, will you?
How's your husband?
Oh, it's hard. He feels responsible.
Well, he's not.
You know, he wouldn't let Paris or me even mention her sister. It's like she never was. But Jim's already made all the arrangements, so that's a step forward. With Tierney, I had to make all the calls and do... Mr. Taylor?
Your other daughter. What was her name?
Tierney.
Do you have a picture?
Tierney had just gotten her license. She was going to the mall. Paris wanted to go. Tierney said no. They had a fight. He said ugly things. Then Tierney went off the road. Her car flipped. She died instantly. I want to think of them as happy. I want to think I didn't fail them.
You didn't. Paris was lost, but that song that you sang to her was still her favorite. You should know that your daughter was loved.
Train's leaving him. Mr. Taylor.